ऑल राइट, हेलो गाइज, वेलकम टू माई चैनल डीजी दी वे फेयर। माई नेम इज़ दीपशिका एंड टूडेज वीडियो इज अबाउट माई 10 डेज विंटर ट्रिप टू लद्दाख, जो कि हमने किया था दिसंबर एंड में। एंड दिस वॉज आवर फर्स्ट ट्रिप टू लद्दाख। वेल, नॉट अ ट्रिप, आई वुड रैदर कॉल इट अ जर्नी, बिकॉज इस जर्नी में आई हैव लर्न सो मैनी थिंग्स एंड दिस ट्रिप हैज चेंज मी एज अ ट्रैवलर, एज अ ह्यूमन बींग। इट्स अ मेमोरेबल ट्रिप फॉर मी एंड ऑल्सो वेरी यूनिक इन सो मैनी एस्पेक्ट। एंड हाउ दिस इज यूनिक, लेट मी टेल यू, बिकॉज इन दिस वीडियो यू विल रेयरली फाइंड एनी अदर व्हीकल और एनी अदर ह्यूमन बींग एक्सेप्ट अस। Now, secondly, we are traveling there in winters. So, in winters, the mercury plummet up to minus 35 to 40 degrees at some places. So, forget about the crowd in this freaking cold. And agar Leh ko chhod dein, to baki hi pure Ladakh mein सिर्फ हमारी कार के अलावा दूर दूर तक हमें कोई व्हीकल, कोई भी कार दिखाई नहीं दे रही थी। And it feels like we ruled over Ladakh for 9-10 days. And I remember a day where now let me continue telling the people about our experiences in Ladakh. Now most of the places except a few were extremely remote and so abandoned that we felt being in another world. And I even remember a day where we started at 8 in the morning from a place and throughout the day we haven't seen anyone, no single human. Now imagine how lonely it would have been. And throughout our trip we have been living in sub-zero temperatures all the time, and sometimes it was like minus 22 degrees. So imagine, the night temperatures used to fall up to minus 30 degrees and in result everything gets freezed in the morning, including fuel in the car too, and people would have to make a huge effort to bring it back to the liquid form. So this was a whole new experience to all of us. And also we traveled with two strangers in this trip, and earlier they were completely unknown to us. Although we share a beautiful bonding now, but to be honest, at the time we were not sure that how it's going to happen. And but it turned out to be the best decision to travel with them, and together this trip became one of the most amazing and memorable trip ever. Now check out the beautiful journey of these five people from Ladakh.
There's a distance between us, it's getting hard to reach out. Haven't seen you in seasons, but all I hear is your voice. I know my limits, you can break me down bad.
So after weeks of planning, now it's time to fly over Himalayas, and trust me, you will curse yourself if you wouldn't get a window seat, because the views outside your window are amazingly breathtaking. Delhi to Leh flight is very short, and while enjoying the views outside, you wouldn't even realize that it's already time to get landed now. It's a wonderful flight over mountains, and when pilot announced that the temperature outside is minus 4 degrees, we really got excited. Now once you enter to airport lobby, you will notice signboards where you can see the information about AMS, do's, don'ts and instructions that need to be followed. Now Ladakh is a high altitude place at 11,800 feet and you are reaching to this altitude just in 1 hour, so you are advised not to exert yourself, also not to sleep so that your body can get acclimatized to this altitude. So even we reached at 9 in the morning, it's an acclimatization day for us and actual journey begins next day. So we explore a little bit of market in the evening today and waiting for tomorrow.
This is day 2. We got packed up quite early for our day tour, and after the breakfast, we came into the hotel lobby. The thermometer showing the temperature minus 9 degree, and it was really thrilling to us. Nevertheless, we excited to explore. Today we are going for Sham Valley tour. The roads were so empty and the landscape is amazingly beautiful. We headed straight to the Alchi Monastery, and in the backyard of monastery, there's a beautiful sight of Indus River flowing through the mountains, and it looked so beautiful. All the water bodies coming along our way were frozen. I've started falling in love with these serene, lonely roads and mountains. After this, we have been to Likir Monastery and Nimmu afterwards. At Nimmu, the confluence of River Indus and Zanskar happens. Green colored Indus and blue colored Zanskar River meet at this point. The rivers are already started to freeze at this time, and the place looks so magical. And we spent a wonderful time over here, standing on this frozen river and admiring the beauty of this nature. Now there's another magical sight, and that is Magnetic Hill. And what actually happens here is that you park your vehicle on road marked with paint, and your vehicle starts moving uphill in defiance of gravity. And last destination for the day is beautiful Shanti Stupa, a white domed architecture which is situated on a hilltop. You can reach here by road or by climbing 500 stairs either. It's day 3 today, and today it's going to be a big day, as we're gonna cross one of the highest motorable road in the world, that is Khardungla Pass. We started early from Leh, and it took us more than 2 hours to reach up to the pass. It was biting cold and windy, and the temperature is minus 22 degrees. This is the lowest temperature I have ever been to in my life. The army personnel warned us not to stay more than 10 to 15 minutes. That is because at this altitude, oxygen remains only half of the oxygen at sea level, and at any moment you can get altitude sickness. Also, the severe cold would make it even worse. So we stayed there for almost 20-25 minutes and we are not able to feel our toes or hand fingers afterwards. We got frozen to the bones. Now let me tell you the most amazing fact about Khardungla, that every year Ladakh Marathon is organized in Ladakh, and of the four races of marathon, the Khardungla Challenge is the highest and toughest ultra marathon in the world. Well, we would now breathe a sigh of relief as we are getting down from this altitude now, and we entered Nubra Valley. The next destination for the day is Diskit Monastery. It is situated at uphill and it has a 32-meter statue of Maitreya Buddha near the monastery, the tallest one in that area, and again an awe-inspiring sight. And once again, it's only us and tranquil nature as far as I could see. This place was no less than a paradise. We stayed there for some time, but another destination for the day was yet to see, and that is Hundar Sand Dunes. So it's a high altitude cold desert and home to double humped Bactrian camels. Now we stayed here overnight and this was the most comfortable sleep we had during our 10 days stay in Ladakh. This is all because of Bukhari, which is also known as Tandoor, and it's a burning wooden heater, and the room remained so cozy and warm that we didn't even realize that it's minus 14 degrees outside. It's day 4 today and we all been waiting for this day since we landed in Leh. The attraction of the day is world famous Pengong Lake. We started early as we need to cover a lot of distance, almost 250 kilometers to reach Pengong. The landscape was so barren and so isolated. And for the next 4-5 hours, we haven't seen anyone. And it was only our car who traveled this entire road stretch alone. At some stretches, there's no road, only dirt terrain. On the other hand, we crossed some sections of flowing Shyok River and other streams on the road. That too frozen due to harsh winter. But despite all this, this is the most scenic route to reach Pengong. It took us 4 to 5 hours to reach Tank Stay, which is our base camp for today. We checked into our guest house, filled our stomach with some snacks and Maggie, and then continued our most awaiting journey towards Pengong. Before that, we stopped at Tank Stay Army checkpost for checking. I couldn't believe how stunning these roads and landscape is. And 4 kilometers before reaching the lake, there's a viewpoint which says first view of world famous Pengong Lake. From here, we'd see a glimpse of this blue lake at a distance, and it looked so marvelous surrounded by barren mountains. A couple of minutes later, we reached at the lake. All the dhabas, camps, guest house, and all other settlements were completely shut due to harsh winter. Again, like all other places, this too was empty and no one was there. Only us and this magnificent blue lake, as far as you could see. It's hard to believe that it's for real, but it is. I'd never seen anything beautiful than this ever. This lake is perched at an altitude of 14,270 feet. It extends from India to China, while only one third part lies in India. Also, this is a saline water lake. That's why it takes more time to get freezed than other lakes and rivers of Ladakh. By now, it's already started freezing on the shores, and by the January end or mid-February, it completely freezes. The temperature was minus 12 degrees and we are quite used to this temperature by now. But the wind is really very strong and powerful that we cannot stand at one place more than 2-3 minutes. It left me spellbound. It's way more beautiful than our imagination. Now we return to our place at Tank Stay, and this was the coldest night of our whole trip due to its being a high altitude place. Also, it snowed at night, so night temperatures fall up to minus 27 degrees. It's day 5 today and we are going back to Leh. On our way back to Leh, we would cross the another one of the highest motorable mountain pass, and that is Changla Pass, at an altitude of 17,600 feet approx. It was biting cold and mercury was minus 20 degrees. Also, oxygen level is very, very low, that we could stand only for 15 minutes. The next destination for the day is Thiksi Monastery, but it was closed at the time. So next we headed to Shay Monastery. Good morning from Leh. It's day 6 today and we are leaving for another destination. We are heading to Chumathang today. Indus River kept flowing along the way throughout our journey. At most of the places it was completely frozen. So one such place we stopped and stepped on the river. It was so slippery, but soon we started enjoying it. We started walking, playing and sliding over it. We have danced over it. It's just a fantastic experience that cannot be described in words. It could only be feel, and that's what we were doing. It's kind of once in a lifetime experience, so we are living every bit of it. After moving little further, we reached Chumathang. Chumathang is situated on the banks of Indus River at 13,000 feet and it has numerous hot water springs and our base camp for tonight. Here we found a stone wall which separates natural hot springs on one side with completely frozen Indus River on the other side. Now imagine coming hot boiling water from the earth and barely few meters away the river is frozen solid due to strong winds and sub-zero temperatures. This is truly incredible. Also, this place was comfortably warm considering the altitude because of its vicinity of the hot springs. And to our surprise, here we got hot running water which we never seen other than Leh Hotel. It's day 7 today at Chumathang and we started very early as we were informed that our journey today is going to be very, very long and tiring. The roads become very treacherous and some patches were extremely in bad condition. We were traveling in the wilderness and reached Kayagar So, which is the first attraction of our day. It is once again a frozen lake at an altitude of 15,436 feet and no one else except us. Now to reach Somoriri Lake from Kyagarso, it took us more than 1.5 hours while distance was only 25 kilometers. The roads to lake are extremely bad. It's a treacherous drive to reach the lake. But once we got first glimpse of lake, it's all frozen in multiple shades. Further moving up, it was completely blue, a perfect picturesque landscape, towering mountains and blue lake perched at 14,832 feet. It's a sight to behold. And before seeing this, I thought that it's only Pangong Lake that has the amazing blue colors. But now looking at this, I become completely speechless. We are having this wonderful, amazing landscape all to ourselves as there's no one except us. It's now time to get to another hidden lake, which is Sokar Lake, and along the way we came across Sumdo village, which was completely abandoned. No one was there, and we got to know that during harsh winter months, people migrate to lower altitude places because it's difficult to survive in such extreme weather conditions. Reaching to Sokar Lake, situated at an altitude of 4522 meters, it's a salt lake. And by now we were traveling in highland of Changthang. This place is extremely remote and we felt being in another world. Moving further for a couple of hours, this road leads to Leh Manali Highway and we were approaching to another high altitude mountain pass, and that is Changlangla Pass, nestled at 5328 meters. This pass was completely secluded than other two passes. There were armed forces and military establishments at other two passes, but here at Changlangla Pass we found no one. This pass looked completely isolated and empty, and once again it was freezing cold up there and the strong winds didn't allow us to stay there for longer. But the beauty of this place cannot be described. It's again a sight to behold, and also this is the highest altitude at Leh Manali Highway. We all started feeling dizziness by now and we got completely exhausted. The first reason was we did not have a proper breakfast in the morning. The second one is we also missed our lunch. And the third reason is today's journey was extremely exhausted and extensively long. Eventually, after traveling for more than 12 hours, we reached Leh and called off the day. Good morning from Leh. It's day 8 today and we are supposed to explore Leh. and first we will be heading to Hall of Fame. So Hall of Fame is an army museum cum war memorial, and it is also maintained by Indian Army. Now this is the place you should never miss while in Leh. The second attraction of the day was Leh Palace, and the palace looked so stunning from outside, and once you get inside the palace you can see amazing views of the city. The breathtaking views of Leh city and surrounding mountains are just amazing and breathtaking. Shanti Stupa can also be seen at a distance. This was our second visit to Shanti Stupa. So this is how we spent our final day in Ladakh. Tomorrow we would be flying back to Delhi, but I have already left a piece of my heart here in Ladakh. And I promised to myself that I will come again, because Ladakh is not a place, it's a feeling. Thank you, Julie.